Alright guys, what is going on and welcome to round number one with the Montreal Canadiens up against the Tampa Bay Lightning here. We're going to look at our lines, we're going to look at their lines, and then we're going to hop into this series here. So, we ended off last episode and we almost traded for James Van Riemsdyk, so I'm hoping that we can put together some goals here in the playoffs against the big man Ben Bishop. If we didn't, maybe trading for a first liner would have been a positive and a right thing to do at the time, but I didn't pull the trigger on any major trades. We were inches away from getting JVR, and there's tons of comments that I have to go over for when we actually have to make some deals and work the free agency, go to the draft, all that good stuff. We'll definitely be looking for a first liner then, but for right now, we are up against the Tampa Bay Lightning, and I know for a fact they're going to have a sick team. It's not going to be an easy series at all. So, here are your lines going into round number one. We got Max Pacioretty, we got Alex Galchenyuk, and Alexander Semin. So, that is our first line. There's a lot of people saying that Alexander Semin is a playoff slouch, but he had 25 goals this year, 51 points. The thing I really like about Alexander Semin is that he's got plus 26. That's really, really good for somebody who is usually known for his lackluster defensive play. I'm very happy with a plus 26. And then we got Devontae Smith-Pelly, Thomas Plekanec, and Brendan Gallagher there. David Desharnais, Lars Eller, and Lance Boma, who has been an absolute machine since coming over to our team. 27 points. He played really, really well since we made the trade with Calgary to acquire Lance Boma. He really turned the whole team around. He changed the dynamic of the Montreal Canadiens. For a third line grinder, we got him, and Pacioretty had like 15 points in like six games. He did really well. A bunch of players just meshed really, really well once we acquired Lance Boma. And the fourth line, Dale Weiss, Torrey Mitchell, and Jacob De La Rose. So we're going to go to the goaltenders here. Obviously, we're starting Carey Price, 95 overall. Best goalie on planet Earth, no questions. And then defensively, Markov, Subban, Petry, Emelin, Nathan Beaulieu, and Tom Gilbert. So we'll check out the Tampa Bay Lightning roster here. One thing that you have to do, it's really, really weird. You have to go into play game. You can't just go to like look at the other team's roster now. It's very, very weird. You actually have to go into the play now screen, edit lines and strategies. You go to edit lines and then you have to click the triangle, which you can bring up view opponents. So very, very weird. That's one of the reasons why I really wanted still slash want to do GM mode on the 360, because I'm not still a huge fan of the NHL 16 menus and how GM mode's played. Honestly, I really dislike it, but we got to work with what we have. Next gen is the future, and oh my god, look at Tampa Bay. Andre Palat, Steven Stamkos, and Ryan Callahan. Holy crap. We got Kucherov, Johnson, and freaking Drouin. Look at their centermen. Filppula, Brian Boyle, Johnson, Stamkos. Oh my god. Killorn, Ashton, Condra, McGinn, Boyle. Holy crap. These guys, we're really going to need to rely on PK Subban and Carey Price to keep the pucks out of the net, because Stamkos can score anytime. Palat, Drouin, Johnson, Filppula, Kucherov. Like, these guys can put the puck in the net at any time. Defensively, oh my god, are you serious? Hedman, Stroman's an 89, oh my god. We got Matthew Carl there, 87. Streit's an 88, Jesus. Braden Coburn's 87, and Garrison is an 86. Oh my god, that's gotta be one of the best defense in the whole league. Oh my god, how is Braden Coburn an 87 overall? Like, are you serious? Mark Streit's even 38, but he's 88 overall. Oh my god. And then Ben Bishop, obviously 89 overall. This is not going to be an easy series. Quite frankly, I'm scared. I am honestly scared. But you know what? We've played well all year. Let's hold a team meeting right now and let's go. Let's start this game off right. Let's start this series off right. We have to look at the big picture here. Build up confidence, get those wins. Honestly, we had a really good year. We have a lot of confidence going into the postseason, but I think we have to look at the big picture. Don't look at the Stanley Cup. Don't look at round two. Don't look at round three. You got to focus on game number one right now. We have to view the big picture here, build up confidence, and get those Bros win. So a few people like that. No one didn't like that, which is kind of nice. And here is your team, and let's go, guys. Game number one, I believe. No, we don't have home ice advantage. They obviously have home ice advantage. So let's go in Tampa Bay, sim the game. Oh boy, all right. Playoff hockey, Montreal, let's go. Period number one. 1-1, Brendan Gallagher and Steven Stamkos. Oh boy, we do not want Stamkos to get hot. All right, 1-1, we got 12 shots, they got 10. Period number two. 2-1, Valtteri Filppula. That's what I'm saying. These guys can put the puck in the net at virtually any time. They can score pretty much whenever they want. The only thing in their way is Carey Price, but Callahan sneaks one by Price there, making it 3-2, making it 3-1, but Gallagher comes right back, making it 3-2. Come on, guys, 5-on-3, you gotta capitalize. 40 shots almost. Oh my god, 4 minutes left. Oh, Lars Eller. Yes, Lars Eller, you beauty on the third line. On the third line, 41 shots, and it pays off. All right, guys, come on. Let's hold it down. Get it to OT. Okay, we're in OT here. Let's go. Times four. Let's go. Come on, guys. You got this. Lars Eller with the big goal. 41 shots. Come on. You can beat Ben Bishop. You beat him 3 times. Price is going to stand on his head. 42 shots. Come on, come on, come on. Someone ice it right now, please. 30 shots, 43. Come on, guys. Tampa Bay, they're dangerous. Don't give them an opening because they will capitalize. Come on, guys. Come on, we need a grindy goal. Power play in OT. How do you not capitalize on that? We're going to double OT here. 46 shots. What an opening game. Oh, my God. Oh, Jacob De La Rose, the rookie. The rook scores the biggest goal of his career. Unreal. Oh, my God. Jacob De La Rose, 47 shots. And Jacob De La Rose, the only one that mattered. What a beauty. The rookie gets a huge goal there. Galli had 2. Palat had 3 helpers there. So we got past that one. That was a game and a half. Holy crap. What a opener. That is a way to start off a playoff series. Let's go, guys. Game number two. Riding the momentum here. First period. 2-1. David Desharnais. Look at the depth. We got Torrey Mitchell and David Desharnais, the fourth and the third liners. There you go. Stamkos has 2 goals in 2 games, though. He's heating up. Period number two. Oh, 2-2. Kucherov. That's what I'm saying. These guys can score literally at any time. They want. Come on, guys. Come on, we got the best goalie in the world, one of the best defensemen in the world. We got this. A great offense. We got great depth. Come on, Alexander Semin. I need you to shut up the critics of... There's lots of people telling me that you're a playoff slouch. We need to shut those people up. Come on, Alexander Semin. You need one here. We're going into OT again. Again, we're going into overtime. Oh my god. This is going to be a series and a half. 32 shots. Come on, boys. Come on, De La Rose, if you want to do it again, man, I'm totally okay with you doing it again. Oh, we go. Oh, shit. Power play. Oh, my God. Huge kill. Huge kill. Back-to-back games with 40 shots. Oh, another big kill. Our penalty kill is on point right now. Oh, my God. 40 shots. Are we going to double OT again? Are you kidding me? Oh, my God. Double OT again. This is a ridiculous playoff series. 45 shots. Holy crap. Oh, my God. Steven Stamkos. You know what? I'm not even that mad. This is some exciting hockey to watch. Holy shit. We put almost 90 shots in 2 games. That is ridiculous. And Stamkos, man, he is just a beast. 3 goals in 2 games. And we split the series in Tampa Bay. That's good. We're going back home to Montreal. The Bell Center. The place is rocking. Montreal does not want any OT. They want this done in regulation. Let's go. First period. Palat gets the only goal. 11-6 are the shots. Come on, guys. In front of your home ice fans. Let's go. 6 shots. We need to double that in the second period. Let's go. Period number two. Okay, we only got 9. 29-9 are the shots, guys. You've got to be kidding me. Oh my god, Brendan Gallagher. Oh, Mark Streit. Are you serious? Coming right back. Literally like 1 minute after. We should not even be in this game. I'm really shocked right now. After putting up almost 90 shots shots in two games. We're struggling to get 20, and we're in the middle of the third period. Come on, guys. All you need is one. Don't worry about the shot totals. You got Carey Price holding it down for you. You got to support your goalie here. You got to get something for Price. Come on, Alexander Semin. Pacioretty, where have you been? Three games and nothing from the first line. Galchenyuk, somebody, 1 minute. Oh, Jonathan Drouin gets the empty netter, and unfortunately, we fall in game number three. We cannot rely on Price to be the first star every single night. There's some concerns. This is what I was concerned about, not scoring any goals. I'm looking for something from the first line, and maybe you guys are right. Maybe you guys are 100% right. Alexander Semin hasn't showed up yet, unfortunately. Maybe we gotta make some sort of a change. Brendan Gallagher's been playing fantastic, but maybe putting Galley on the first line will spark something. Alexander Semin has done nothing so far. He's a minus one, 15 shots, where Brendan Gallagher has three goals. He's still a minus one, got nine shots. Maybe just Alexander Semin's getting no luck, but we have to get something going here. We have to put some goals on the big man. Game number four, most important game of the series, hands down. Let's go, guys. Come on. Play for your goalie. First period. 1-0. Max Pacioretty. There is the first line. There you go. Patches, baby. Let's go. Period number two. Oh, 1-1. Carter Ashton. These guys will not go away. We need to put up at least two goals here in the third period to even have a chance. Come on, guys. You know what to do. 5-on-3 if you don't capitalize on this. Oh, my God. Really? 5-on-4? Come on. Just put the puck in the net on the power play. Is it really that hard? Come on. Come on, guys. You got this. 5-on-4. Again, two power plays in a row. Oh, there it is. Alexander Galchenyuk. There's the first line. Oh, Alex Galchenyuk again. Oh, there you go. That is what I'm talking about. Maybe putting Brendan Gallagher on the first line really helps. Because we have three goals from our first line, and that is hopefully going to push us to win this hockey game. 38 shots again. There you go. Maybe we had two off games. Max Pacioretty gets the empty netter. That is four goals from our first line. This coach X-Tech, he knows what he's doing. Pacioretty had 4 points. Galchenyuk had three, and Price again had a phenomenal game. So let's actually have a look here at did Brendan Gallagher do anything here? Let's see. Looks like Brendan Gallagher didn't even have a point, but that whole line just did amazing. I mean, aside from Brendan Gallagher, 3 points from Galchenyuk and 4 points from Max Pacioretty. Pacioretty went off. Give that guy a player of the game card. Holy crap. What a beast. What a monster. So Alexander Semin is actually pretty happy with playing on the second line. So I'm cool with that. I am definitely okay with that. We got a huge, huge game here. Game number five. We got to go to some player morale really quickly. Who wants to talk? Jacob De La Rose, extra minutes. You know what, buddy? You have been working hard for it. You scored that huge double OT goal. We have found a balance that seems to work, and he liked that a lot. So there you go. Everything's going perfect right now. Look at all the greens. It's looking beautiful. Come on, guys. This is a huge game. We've won in Tampa Bay before. We can do it again. Let's go, guys. Come on. Period number one. Okay, 17-3 are the shots. Are you kidding me? Come on, you guys. Something's got to happen here. Ben Bishop's one of the best goalies in the league, but we could beat him. I know we can. Patches had 4 points last game. Let's go. Period number two. Are you serious? Ryan Callahan, we have 29 shots. They have 11. Where is this ice tilt at? Oh, my goodness. Come on, guys. Let's go. Let's go. We haven't had a shot yet. 5 minutes in, no shot. Almost 10 minutes in. Okay, we finally got a shot. Jesus, that is not a way to start the period. They have all the momentum in the world here. Come on, guys. Come on. Come on. Come on. You're not going to do me like that. After you had such a dominating performance last game, you're struggling to score a goal. Come on, guys. I'm really weighing on my first line here. Someone, Alexander Semin. Oh, my God. Maybe you guys are right. Maybe Alexander Semin is only a guy that you can play in the regular season, because in the playoffs, he's doing shit, and we get shut out. 36-19 were the shots. Ben Bishop, you just played phenomenal. Oh boy. We're down 3-2 here. Potentially our season's over. 50 wins and our season could be done just like this. Come on, guys. You know what to do. We beat them before. We can do it. Come on, let's go. First period, 1-0 Ryan Callahan, that fucking guy. Period number two, still 1-0. We haven't even scored a goal. That was my thing, man. Not getting a player who could score goals. Maybe that was a big mistake. Not getting JVR or someone like Bobby Ryan. Someone who could really put the puck in the net, because sometimes we go off, and sometimes we have games where people can put up 4 points, but aside from that, I mean, it's been lackluster at best for the goal support. Carey Price has played phenomenal. You can see another night where he's made 30 stops, but they're just getting no love from the offense. No love at all. Power play, for the love of God, please, please, please. Oh my goodness, this is so beyond frustrating. Are you serious? 31 shots, and we can't beat Ben Bishop. He's not getting back-to-back shutouts. Come on, guys. Come on. Don't do this to me. Are you kidding me? That is just a performance that is just unacceptable after all that momentum in game number 4, and you just shit the bed in games 5 and 6, and that is just, that's really, really disappointing. Carey Price, I apologize on behalf of the team, because you did not deserve that at all. That is really, really frustrating. We scored 4 goals there, 3 goals there, 1 goal, 4 goals, no goals, no goals. 11 goals in 6 games? That's really unacceptable, guys. We got kicked out in round number 1 against Tampa Bay. Good luck. I hope they do well. They're going to be a very scary team going forward here. But you know what? We got kicked out of the playoffs. We got a lot of work to do in the offseason now that I'm looking at it. We need to get someone who can score some goals. Yeah, Alexander Semin, he can put up 25 goals in the regular season, but playoff time comes, and he didn't really do a whole lot. I can't just point my finger at Alexander Semin, because there's a lot of players who probably didn't put up any points whatsoever. Pacioretty, Galchenyuk, yeah, they had the one good game. That's great. That's all fine and dandy. But when you don't, when you were in game 6 of being eliminated, you're potentially going home after that, and you don't even get one goal. I mean, yeah, we're playing against Ben Bishop, and I mean, that's just really, really frustrating. It's a super frustrating way to go out, and hopefully we will not be in that predicament come next year, because I'm hoping that we are going to get some serious stuff done in the offseason here. I'll have a look here at everything. Calgary won the Stanley Cup, actually. Holy crap. Let's do a whole little playoff wrap-up, all that good stuff. So that's really shitty. That's a terrible way to go out. I'm legitimately upset at that. That's no fun at all. Manager Ross, how do you check all the... I gotta go to stats, actually. Stats all the way over here. So we're gonna have a look at the playoff tree, then go into all the standings. So in the West, that's how it looked like. Chicago made it to the Western Conference semifinals there, getting kicked out by Colorado, actually. And Colorado eventually lost to Calgary, and then Calgary actually beat Tampa Bay 4-2. So that's really, really impressive. For year number 1, that's extremely, extremely impressive. Impressive. So after us, Tampa Bay went on to sweep Ottawa, and then they took the New York Rangers to 7 games, obviously winning that, and then Calgary took them 4-2 in the Stanley Cup final. So the Stanley Cup is back in Canada. Unfortunately, it's not on the East Coast, though, where we want it to be. So Pacioretty and PK Subban are 2 leaders, obviously led the team in points. Brendan Gallagher had 3. I mean, aside from that, no one else really did anything. Galchenyuk had 3 points in 1 game. Didn't have a point for the other 5. That is just, like, where did people, like, oh, that's so frustrating. No one was even there at all. Alexander Semin didn't do a thing. 1 assist. I mean, he shot the puck, had 21 shots. I think he probably, like, led our team in shots. Oh, no, PK did. But, I mean, 20 shots, and maybe the puck just wasn't going his way. I don't know what it is, but that is an unacceptable way to go out, and we really need to work on our scoring in the offseason for sure. So looks like points-wise, Steven Stamkos, TJ Brody, actually, holy crap, Sean Monahan, Palat, there you go. Looks like since they acquired Dougie Hamilton, the Calgary Flames are, they did the right thing for sure. Check out the awards. So Calgary won the Cup, President's Trophy went to Ottawa, Clarence, obviously Calgary, and then Tampa won the Prince of Wales. So Art Ross went to Ovi, the Hart went to Hiller. That's really, really impressive for Hiller to win the Hart. James Norris went to Erik Karlsson for the second time in a row. Lady Bing went to Karlsson. Calder obviously went to McDavid. Conn Smythe went to Jonas Hill. That's pretty impressive as well. Vezina went to Hiller. Holy shit. Hiller taking home some hardware. Bogosian won the Bill Masterton. The Frank J. Selke went to Taze. Ted Lindsay went to Hiller. Holy crap. Tyler Seguin won the Maurice Rocket Richard, and there are your awards. So, unfortunately, we didn't take home any hardware. Is there any player award? Oh, you can actually check out the player awards for the AHL. So, did anyone take home any hardware from the Ice Caps? Doesn't really look like it, unfortunately. So, one thing I wish it had was their stats. So, maybe for the Calder, say, right beside McDavid's name, maybe have, like, the stats for the year. I think that'd be kind of cool. That's something they could probably add for next year. That'd be a pretty cool thing to do. But aside from that, we need to work on our scoring. You guys know what needs to be done, and I need your help. I need my assistant GMs in a big way. I'm going to be really leaning on you guys for the offseason, so please let me know what you're thinking in the comments down below. Here's a quick look at everyone's overall. Just in case anyone went up, nope, everyone seems to look like the exact same, unfortunately. So there it is, guys. Thanks for watching. Alexander Semin's at 82 now. Oh my god, shit, that's not good at all. But thanks for watching, and I really need your guys' help for the next episode, and I will talk to you guys in the off season.